Well, he was born, 61 years ago. He's 61 at this point. He was has been a member of Hamas pretty well since its founding in 1987. In 1989, he was charged by Israel with killing two Israelis, and he was jailed for 22 years. He was finally released, rather ironically, in 2011, as part of a swap that enabled the Israelis to get an IDF trooper who had been held in Gaza for 5 years, Gilad Shalit. About 1,000 Palestinians held in Israeli jails were released at that time, and Yahya Sinwar was one of them. He steadily risen up the ranks, and he became leader of Hamas in Gaza in 2017. But his appointment now as overall leader, overall political leader of Hamas, really is makes it very difficult for negotiations with Hamas to take place. He is obviously in hiding in the tunnels within Gaza. And in order to communicate with him, it's been necessary for those doing the negotiations held by Egypt and Qatar to negotiate to send someone who is based in Qatar to negotiate, and then to get messages, really handwritten messages, through into the tunnel network to Yahya Sinwar. And it's taken often days to get a response back from him about the negotiations, which is one of the reasons why they've taken so long. But he is believed to be very much on the hard line faction with Hamas, so his appointment as the overall leader really makes Hamas closer, I think, to Iran and to Syria, and makes it very difficult to think that there are going to be some serious negotiations now towards a ceasefire and towards release of the remaining Israeli hostages. So it we'll have to wait and see. In the meantime, of course, we're also waiting to see just how Iran will retaliate for the killing of Ismail Haniyeh about 10 days ago in Iran. The Supreme Leader has directed that there should be an attack on Israel directly as in punishment for this. Just how this will happen, we don't know. We're clearly waiting to see what the developments are. But Iran has several means available to us. It also has Hezbollah, which has promised retaliation against Israel over the killing of one of Hezbollah's senior operatives, Fuad Shukr, about the same time that the, or just shortly before the killing of Ismail Haniyeh. I think we can be pretty sure that Hezbollah and Iran will coordinate in some way, the way that they will carry out their attacks. There's a very it's very likely as well that they will seek to get the Houthis in Yemen, who already fired on Israel before and actually hit a target within Tel Aviv earlier in July, to be part of this. Quite possibly some pro-Iranian factions, militant groups inside Syria and Iraq. And we've already had a pro-Iranian militant group in Iraq fire on a US base in Anbar province in northeastern or northwestern, it is, Iraq, injuring five US servicemen. So the tensions in the region are extremely high at present, and we'll have to wait and see how they develop. Quite clearly, the United States has said it will help Israel protect itself. We have a carrier battle group in the Persian Gulf, and we also have Israeli, sorry, but we also have US and British military assets in the naval assets in the Eastern Mediterranean. So they're ready to help shoot down anything that Iran sends or Iran's allies send at Israel, but we're still waiting to see when that happens. He has the role that Ismail Haniyeh had when before he was killed in Iran about 10 days ago. So he is the overall leader, and he is believed to be more hardline, if you can talk in terms of relativities here, than Ismail Haniyeh was. So, I mean, as well as that, it's going to be very difficult for even members of Hamas who are outside Gaza to be able to communicate with him. We do know that Turkey, which does have an interest in Palestinian affairs, a strong interest, was actually hoping that a different person named Khaled Mashal, who is based in Doha, that he would take the leadership role. So Turkey won't be happy that it's Sinwar. But I think particularly the negotiations themselves are going to be that much more difficult, and it's not good news at all for the families of Israelis who are held in Gaza presently. It's going to be very difficult to get any concessions from Hamas with him as overall leader. It's also going to be very difficult for negotiators to communicate with him. We don't even know at this stage who Yahya Sinwar might designate to carry out the negotiations, assuming that they are going to continue. At this stage, we don't even have a timing for negotiations to take part. And with the Ismail Haniyeh having been killed, there is now no obvious negotiating party for Israel, Egypt, and Qatar. So it's not good news at all overall, and it means that the conflict, which is 10 months old today, it's on the 7th of August, it means that the conflict could go on for quite some time.